they have experienced worsening droughts, floods, heat waves, and cyclones for several decades. And the question is, what do we do about it? How can we actually help people continue to live their lives and have families and be healthy? What this cluster provides is a catalyst for coming together and thinking about these problems in an integrated way across fields. One of the key components of our project is that we want it to be community-led and led by our partners in South Asia, but we want to be able to take all of the expertise that we have at Harvard and help our partners in South Asia to achieve their goals around climate resilience.
Our objectives are twofold. One, to work with local scientists, climate scientists, to develop a vulnerability index based on sea level projections that enables communities and governments to anticipate what is going to happen along their coastline. Second is to equip communities through best practices with cost-effective solutions about how to protect their communities and their livelihoods. So for me, this is very important because climate change is a global challenge and the world will have to respond.
People used to think about climate change as something that, oh, it's 50 years off, it's 100 years off. But we're always looking at the next 5, 10, 20 years. So if you look at a couple of decades, then methane stands out as exceptionally important. The next step is a true soup to nuts approach to methane emissions reductions. That we start with the science in terms of detection of concentrations in the atmosphere. Then looking at the engineering of alternative technologies, both existing ones and prospective ones, to reduce emissions, and that is of exceptional importance.
We're concentrating on understanding the effectiveness and the consequences of corporate net zero commitments and targets. We need to reach, as a world, net zero emissions but around mid-century. Part of our goal is going to be able to understand how policies and different types of incentives are leading to companies being more or less effective, are translating those goals into actionable regimes and progress towards those outcomes.
There are communities who have developed over the ages workforces and knowledge bases built on old energy systems. And now, as a nation, the United States is trying to advance a more sustainable energy transition. The basic overall of the cluster is to actually enable communities that are going to be most hurt by the positive changes that we as a nation are making in terms of advancing an energy transition and bring them along by addressing the problems they face, the social costs they face, and maybe the political conflicts that have emerged over an energy transition.